Hello and welcome. This week is full of exciting news. Many good things happened last week, and today I bring you an update on our beloved lossless scaling, which introduced frame generation 3, promising to triple your FPS without significantly compromising performance or increasing input lag. That's what we'll be discussing in today's video. For those interested, simply update your lossless scaling to any version above 2.9 and enable frame generator 3x in the frame generation options. Before we dive into our tests, let's talk a bit about the updates this new version has received. If you're not familiar with lossless scaling, I'll leave a video in the card for you to watch later, where I did a complete analysis of this program, testing it on native PC games and emulators. Speaking of updates, they primarily present frame generator 3x, which can generate 2 new frames for every real frame, potentially tripling your FPS. However, the 3x method increases GPU load by approximately 1.7 times compared to the 2x method, where LSFG generates 1 AI frame per real frame. We'll compare the two methods later in this video. Additionally, LSFG 2.1 and 1.1, which are used on more basic GPUs, have been optimized and are now 20% faster than in previous versions of lossless scaling. They claim that the 3x method does not add additional latency compared to the 2x method, but frame latency can be higher if the entire GPU load is being utilized. To get a better experience and smoother frame generation, it is recommended to lock the game's frame rate to about 1/3 of the monitor's total frame rate when using the X3 method. The minimum base frame rate recommended for both X2 and X3 is 30 FPS for 1080p resolution and 40 FPS for 1440p resolution. Now, the frame generator should no longer exceed the monitor's maximum frame rate. Previously, LS rendered all frames and discarded the frames the monitor couldn't display, but now it will skip the excess frames. This brings the same result as in previous versions, but with much more efficiency in hardware utilization. The first game I tested was Cyberpunk 2077. First, let's show a side-by-side comparison to see the amount of artifacts generated. As you can see, in this new update, it is very clear that with LS enabled, the visual quality is much higher, presenting less blur. To run this test, Cyberpunk was running at maximum settings, with ray tracing also at maximum, without any in-game frame generation or scaling. As stated in the update notes, GPU consumption is much higher, being about 45% with LS disabled and reaching 70% with LS enabled. In the case of Cyberpunk, I recommend enabling LS only if you have performance issues with the game, as the in-game frame generator already does a good job. I didn't try enabling both frame generators because I think generating frames on top of frames that already have small errors could result in a bad outcome. Before we move on to emulators, if you enjoy updates on lossless scaling, please leave a like so the video can reach even more people. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to the channel for new weekly content. Finally, I made a comparison between frame generator X2 and X3, where we can see that X3 generates an additional frame for each native frame. As mentioned in the updates, regarding GPU usage, X3 uses about 5 to 10% more of our GPU. In my opinion, the graphical quality of X3 is superior, with X2 presenting more motion blur than the X3 version. Regarding smoothness, the image on X3 is much smoother, and there seems to be no difference between the visual artifacts generated in the two methods. I tested on PCSX2 with a game that has one of the worst frame rates on this console, Metal Gear Solid 3, where some cutscenes reach around 20 FPS due to the graphics being so ahead of their time. Before discussing the results, keep in mind that on the PlayStation 2, for the game to appear to be running at 60 FPS, it duplicates the frames, meaning the game is running at 30 FPS, but two frames are always the same, only changing on the odd frame. Even in areas with more vegetation, the frame rate seems much smoother than the native frame rate. However, since the frame rate is low and the console's native rendering duplicates a certain number of frames, the result might not be as satisfactory. Perhaps if it were running a game that natively runs at 60 FPS, the results would be better. Another emulator we tested was PPSSPP. In this case, unlike PCSX2, we have native 30 FPS, where we can generate 3 times more frames, reaching 90 FPS. The game experience became much more enjoyable. Clearly, using a hack that unlocks 60 FPS and being able to use 180 FPS with LS would be better. But on the PSP, I found the use of LS very pleasant since most games run at 30 FPS due to it being a portable console. In Vita 3K, there were also decent improvements, running the game Dead or Alive 5+, which runs at 60 FPS. I was able to scale it up to 120, and it was very smooth without interfering with combo execution. Keep in mind that the capture card I used to record this gameplay has a limit of 120 FPS, so it wouldn't be possible to scale the game to 180 FPS. However, if connected directly to a monitor with DisplayPort, it would be possible to run even the PS Vita at 180 FPS smoothly. We also tested our PCS3 with one of the most unstable games, Metal Gear Solid 4. Despite significant improvement, there seems to be something odd. Even though the game is running at 30 FPS, LS shows 120. Our PCS3 already has a somewhat high input delay, and LS makes things a bit worse. In my opinion, in a shooter or fast-paced game, you will likely have difficulties. I also think the result wasn't as satisfactory as with other projects, so use it only if you are facing many FPS issues and keep in mind that it is not the best experience. Lastly, I used LS on Sudachi, testing Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom, leaving the game at its default FPS, which is 30 FPS, and generating frames through LS for a 90 FPS experience, proved to be a very smooth option with highly satisfactory gameplay. I ran a small test to check the input delay and didn't notice anything severe, besides the fact that this emulator demands more from the processor than the GPU, making it easy to use LS without compromising graphical performance. Overall, this edition of Frame Generator X3 has an excessive GPU consumption, but undeniably delivers surprising results. The input delay is almost minimal and will be imperceptible to most people. The downside is that it doesn't work well if you leave a game with unlocked FPS, or if the game is experiencing many FPS drops. Hope you enjoyed the video, and see you next time!